All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to another exciting edition of whatever the hell this is. This being, of course, the discussion panel for my YouTube channel about music and all of the other things that I enjoy doing for the most part. Let me first comment by admitting that, one, I have been way behind schedule. Last semester at college kind of kicked my ass and kept me really busy along with work. Two, there are a number of videos I have not made responses to. More importantly is this guy in Russian. I don't know your name and I am sorry. I don't understand how you mean that you could not get the recording thing to record. I'm assuming that you mean like when you armed it and then it started recording, like your wave didn't start showing up, which means that it wasn't gathering an input, which probably means that, one, there's an input selection problem, or something along those lines, like you haven't set your input microphone, possibly, or you have multiple inputs, like if you have a video or a sound card, like an auxiliary sound card, or a front bus mic port, like on the front of a desktop tower, and another microphone port on your computer. Like my laptop has the built-in microphone, which you're hearing me with now, not my good headset. I'm sorry that the audio quality on this is going to be off. And I have this little microphone port on the side down here. If I'm using one or the other, I have to make sure I switch those around. Like if you go down here to right-click your sound control properties, you go to recording devices, you'll see that like right now I'm popping up in the levels here because I am talking currently. You can actually, if you have multiple things set up, you can actually finagle those around and choose which one of those you want to be your default whenever you're using a different one than currently set as default. So you got to make sure it's set as a default too. Otherwise, sometimes it depends on what operating your system working with too. Different video card or sound cards and video cards, sound cards and stuff will pick up on input selections a lot better than others. And I'm, you know, it's a big big thing you got to remember when doing troubleshooting anything digital and hardware issue related is that, one, you've got to make sure that you really need to include information pertaining to OS, hardware, software, like everything we're using, so that way people like me that are trying to help you troubleshoot it can help you diagnose your problem a little bit better. Other than that, the reason I haven't responded to some of these video things or comments is apparently I have to log back into my account, and I apparently don't know what the password is. and I really don't want to deal with the retrieval of the lost password thing, and I do apologize about that. But with that being said and done, I will get back on that and try to be better about that here in this upcoming year. I had some grandiose ideas for last year, and that definitely didn't get done because of college. I graduate in a couple months. Hoorah! Nothing pertaining to music, so don't get excited there. I would like to go ahead and give a shout out to all of our newest subscribers. I just looked at this not too long ago, and we're up to 220! Currently sitting numbers are 220 at 73,000 nearly views. That's pretty good. I mean, considering how much unattention I pay to this. So appreciate you guys who pay attention to the channel every once in a while. I will try to work on some stuff. I'm still open to suggestions if there's things that you don't understand or would like me to show you how to do on the software. I get a lot more focused than whenever I have a goal than whenever I just kind of have to shoot in the dark and hope it's something people want to watch. So if you got something you really want to know, always remember to drop me a line or inbox me. The inbox on this, I think, still works. I've been able to correspond with someone that I did a product review for, and stuff like that. Like, that'll work out better than just leaving comments on the page. So please do that. Or I set up a Facebook page that I don't think is working. And yeah, I don't know about the rest of those. Or there's other ways to try to get a hold of me, but try to inbox me here first. Or this is my email, one of my emails. Like, that's a link to this account, and I'll get them there if you're having some major issue, and I will try to assist the best I can. But while I've got your attention while we're here, let's talk about something that I don't do very well, which is media marketing and things like that. Now, I know I kind of talked about logo building as a basis for something before. It's kind of, you know, you want to have good material and stuff like that, but for a lot of people branching out right now, like, they struggle to find good places to to make an online presence. And that and anymore, that's the best way to do it is online. Now you can tell every person in the town you live in, hey, I'm a musician, check out my music. And a lot of times, you're not gonna get a lot of people to actually, well, first of all, check it out because people's interests are so diverse, especially when it comes to music anymore. I would show you the subgenre page of music pages on Wikipedia just as an example of how many stupid subgenres there are that exist. And there are a lot, and I really don't want to because it would take forever. I will never subscribe to this guy. Do not tell me to subscribe to him. But two of the things that I would suggest to you, if you haven't already looked into them, and that are kind of big deals in the music thing, at least I think they're big deals. Only because of the fact that of their ease of use and the subscriber base of people that are on them that follow them currently, and their integration with social media, is first Reverb Nation. Reverb Nation is an amazing tool if you're actually a performing band. It can actually help you book shows. One of my friends' bands uses the. Actually, I have a couple friends' bands that use this, and they like it a lot more than they gets credit for. And Reverb's been around for a long time. You can tell my account's not set up very good because I really don't care. I don't really do a lot of stuff anymore, so I don't really give a crap as much as I probably should. But Reverb can be a really really useful tool to kind of get exposure. You link it up with your Facebook. You can set it to your region, your town, and it actually ranks you based on fan activity and movement and plays and songs about how good you're trending in your area, which can be a pretty good, I guess you'd say it'd be a demographic maybe tool or like logistical tool to figure out if you think you're doing well in your region or what might you be able to change. You can connect with people in a variety of ways about that. The other one is SoundCloud. SoundCloud, I rather enjoy. I don't really have a lot of friends on it because also I don't really keep up with SoundCloud a lot either. I don't really do a lot of this stuff, but you can also link this into your Facebook where you can have it to where every video or audio thing, sorry, this is audio. SoundCloud is only for audio, and with their pro service, I think you can do, I don't remember. I think they were talking about it at one point in time. I don't think they ever added it. But you can link your other social media stuff in here. I don't know why this is showing up on here. But that also brings up another good point about MySpace. MySpace has actually transformed into a pretty good musical hub. Do I still have a MySpace, really? Oh my god, I do. That's amazing. We're learning together. Isn't that amazing? But MySpace has transformed into a almost a media social media hub for people. I know when they introduced the bands thing in like 2004 or 5, it kind of took off for a while. But it didn't ever make waves. And since I believe it was Fox bought out MySpace from the original proprietors, maybe it's good enough for you. I don't know. But I would definitely look into using Reverb Nation and SoundCloud more often if you don't already. Get involved. Tag your songs based on the genres they're in. Find people who listen to those genres. Like them as an artist or like them as a friend, because there's a lot of people on SoundCloud who don't post music, and you can actually just use it as a listening resource too. You don't actually have to ever post any songs. People make accounts all the time just to listen to music. But the other thing is also, but with the integration of Facebook, is that it can also direct people to your SoundCloud page to get them involved with it as well. Of course, now there's also, what is it? The remix comps website has a good forum section. And then, as I always boast about with through Acid Planet, because Acid Planet's my home and my original breakthrough source, which me and my friends began with. There are a lot of musical forum places and communities to get involved with. The thing is, if you really want exposure and you really want to try to get out there, you gotta do foot soldier work. That's essentially what it is. It's all about getting out there and. Getting out there and letting people know you're there. I know this was really redundant right then. Don't have to tell me. But you should focus on that. Having a presence is one thing, but managing that presence to get more attention, more views, more garnering, that takes a little bit more work. Even YouTube can be a great resource because everyone goes to YouTube. You can set up a channel and do one of those really ridiculous like song uploaded with a weird video slideshow in the background for your music, or just have like a still image. You know, it doesn't matter as long as it's out there somewhere, because the biggest thing is hosting. You want to be hosted, and you don't really want to pay for it. Now, unless you're a big man, or you know, maybe you've got a good deal, maybe you know someone who's running a server and you want to host a website cheap. I mean, having your own website is a great way to direct traffic to you specifically, but at the same time, you gotta weigh cost benefit ratio and analysis on that. It's like, you know, is it gonna be worth it if you end up having to spend money on a website? Is it gonna be worth it to do that if you're not actually making good money at this yet, or if you're just starting out? You know, a lot of people, if you're gonna do it the cheap and easy way, like if you've I don't know, pirated the software, hint hint people, or other things like that, you know, you're not looking to spend money to get in the game. You're wanting to kind of get your feet wet first, and then, you know, maybe if it takes off, if you get a deal, or maybe if you make some money, play some gigs, then, you know, then you turn it all legitimate, which is a good way to do it too. I'm not, you know, not knocking anyone for doing stuff like that, because some of us have roots in there. I'm not saying anyone in particular, especially people I know that are on my fans list on this page. But, you know, that's one way you can do it as well. All right. Well, with that, welcome to 2014, a year where much more will probably be done on this channel than the year previous. Only because since I graduate, I will have an entire half of the year to do new things. And I have a massive, awesome, powerful new desktop that I have built, but I'm not currently working on, like, as in doing this video with, because I haven't moved my software over yet. And, but once we do that, it'll be good. So, like I said, send me your ideas and requests, even if it's non-musically related. I'm always up for a good discussion topic, and I want to try and do some stuff with this later. So that's me done rambling for now. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, as always, again, inbox me or drop the comments on the thing, and I'll probably respond via the inbox, or I'll make a video denouncing out your intelligence. All right, and have a good night, people.